Ravina, personally, I love the I mean all your films that were very successful were great. Mohra and Mast and the Mast Girl still lives on and follows you everywhere.
That is, can't shake off. Whatever I try, can't shake off.
And now, like, you know, I mean, from that, then you did Aks, which was like one of my favorite films, though, you know, it didn't do well box office wise, but and then now you have a Bombay Velvet coming up. So tell us something
But
about.
you know, at that time, I must tell you, that was the saddest part, because when you made when you do intelligent cinema, you'd be critically acclaimed, but box office you'd come up with a dud. And when you did complete cinema, where even I would not want to go and watch, which most of them I didn't watch actually. I've not seen my own movies, some of them, most of them. Okay. Let me not reveal too much. But then you would not want to watch them. But those used to be like commercially the biggest hits. So you didn't know whom to please. You wanted to please the critics, or you want to please your masses, or you want to see your producer happy so that he makes another movie and sends you another check so that you're in the other movie. So you didn't know what to do at that time. There was that phase. But luckily now, I think we've entered a phase now where you know, intelligent cinema, well made, are also very big commercial successes.
You know, also one interesting thing that I noticed, and Pallavi is here and Deepa and various other members from the fraternity, that at one point you know, like, you had a young heroine come into the business. She had to do the glamorous roles, and if she made the right choices and was commercially successful, she did those films. And then, like, when you said, okay, now the roles are drying up and now I'm going to do something which is heroine centric, and you know, that happened towards a later phase in their career, so to speak, you know, usually I'm saying. And it was like an issue-based film, so it was seen as too heavy and too preachy and message hair social, and somehow it didn't get as wide, though some of them did work, like Damini and various others. But you know, I'm talking probably of the 80s and 90s, when, you know, Zakhmi Aurat and all these kind of films were made once in a way, and somehow they didn't really catch the imagination as much as what you see films do today, where you have a heroine play a very prominent role, or probably shoulder the responsibility of making it into a success. Can you tell us a little bit about that, having seen that phase of cinema?
See, around in the 80s, I must have been 6 or 7 years old, or 10 years old, depends on 81, 82, 83, 84. So about the 80s, I do remember that it was a time where suddenly these masala kind of films and these South remakes were coming in and stuff. And even we used to watch them when we were kids. Who can forget, you know, that song of Shri Ji's, where all the ghadas are falling and the oranges are rolling down the hills and she's dancing in the middle of them, and Jitu Ji doing his very famous steps. Yeah, we all grew up on that. You know, we were kids at that time. But yes, somewhere along in the 90s, that's when I started working in, I think, 87, 88 was when I started assisting my dad. I was in the 8th standard. And I remember coming to Pune for a schedule when she was doing a film for my dad. I was very little at that time. And that was again one of the offbeat films where Pallavi was there, and I don't remember the rest of the stuff. Salim Ghaus. And my father, for the first time, was also trying an offbeat film from the regular Khuddar and this and that that he had made. And, you know, we did grow up seeing this kind of cinema also happen. Masoom had happened. In the 80s, Lekin had happened. There was
Ijazat was
Ijazat,
80s.
sorry, I was going to say Ijazat was also 80s. So those kind of offbeat films were also happening, and one did see them as well, and they were commercial success too.